It can be a truly incredible experience when you put in a whole lot of work into whatever time frame, and you finally get to the point where you get to display that work and you get to just reap all of the progress that you've been pushing for and expecting. I did the USPA Spring Fling meet here at Rab Fitness, and I have to say it was just an awesome experience. Top to bottom, I loved this whole time. It was great that not just the lifting, but the people. I had some really great conversations. I was inspired and refreshed, and it got even more excited to train and improve and keep doing this, keep working through my own journey and getting better along the way. So the lifting itself, I had a very solid meet. I came in with a pretty specific plan, and I was able to, for the most part, carry it out almost exactly. So I was really stoked about that. Starting on the squats, I always get nervous when it comes to squats. This is my first meet without knee wraps, and so I was especially nervous. I didn't have something to go off of, and the heaviest I had gone in this entire training cycle was 600 for two triples. I did that 2 weeks ago and decided that would be a good opener. Since I could triple it pretty consistently, and it ended up paying off. I was very pleased with the way the depth felt in this meet, and I do have some little nitpicky things for myself on the technique, but overall, I was very pleased with being able to hit that opener, take a conservative jump up to 628, and then take my third attempt 650 goal, which I actually planned this attempt about 3 months ago. I said I want a 650 when I go to Rab, and pretty much structured the entire training block for this number. This is the one that I wanted. This is the one that I came here for, and I was able to pull it off. You're gonna see, spoiler alert, I get this lift, and I'm pretty pleased with the depth. My hips do shoot back a bit, but I felt in control of the weight the whole time. I just am gonna need to put a couple of, a little bit more focus on some different areas in my training to make sure that I am more prepared to keep my hips under me. I think my quad strength can come up a little bit, and I have a couple of technical cues that I like to work on. I never mean to freak out like that. I get so excited, and it's the reason right now that my voice is so just completely trashed, because I was doing that a lot every time I had something go well. This was my opener on bench, 358 point something. The kilo conversions always throw me off. Felt very strong, but at the same time, I got really dehydrated between the squat and the bench. So I was cramping up my back, my forearms, my legs, everything, and I had downed a whole Powerade. And by the time I hit my third attempt, I was starting to kick in. I was losing some of the cramps, but it made the pressing a lot more stressful than I think it needed to be. And this 391 is a 6.3 pound lifetime PR, and it's gonna be ugly. It is probably the ugliest rep I've ever been able to finish. I was really surprised that I was able to do it, and it starts moving, and it was such a grinder. There was a couple of times I really wanted to lift my butt very badly, but I told myself, you know what, keep it down. There's enough people here to catch you if you try to cut your head off of the bar, and was able to grind that one out. Definitely have some more things to work on the bench press, but again, that's a lifetime PR with the flat footed and the head down, which is what one of my goals was coming into this meet. So far we have hit the goal on the squat, hit the goal on the bench press, and then moved on to the deadlift. I was not sure how this was gonna go. My deadlift progress has been really great in the gym, or in the garage, I suppose. And I did notice on that opener that there was a little bit, the bar felt a little sticky at the bottom. It felt a little strange. Not sure if part of it was pulling off of carpet, but I think a big part of it was the fact that the weights themselves are so much thinner, and so I got a lot less whip from this bar than I do with my big iron plates in my garage. And so 738 moved really well. I felt very confident that I could hit a 750, but I've already done that, or at least in my mind I did. So I came for the 760, and I think I was just an inch or two away. If I could have held a better position for another inch or two, I think I would have been able to accelerate that weight up and be able to pull it. But because the weights were so thin, I just couldn't get through that little sticking point. However, I was just curious and a little bit frustrated with myself that I missed a weight that I felt like I should have gotten. So after that attempt, I went back. The fourth flight had just started their deadlift, so there wasn't a whole lot of people left in the warm-up room, and I went and just loaded up 765 because I couldn't fit 760 with the 10 or with the 5 and the 2.5 that I would have had to put on. And Ben followed me down after one of his deadlifts, and a few other people walked in. I didn't plan on doing this in front of people. I was just doing it for me. And this 765, I had something weird happen there. I think my leg just kind of straightened out on its own, but I ended up pulling it, and that is a 15-pound PR after missing 5 pounds less on the platform. So that left me with a 1780.2 pound total, an 807 kilogram total. That is obviously, since I've never competed without wraps, that's a PR. That actually is also 5 pounds heavier than my last wrapped meet, which was pretty exciting, mostly thanks to the squat and the bench press. Because the last time I did a wrap squat, it was about a year ago, and it didn't go the way I wanted it to. So very pleased with this meet. I know that if the conditions that I trained in were the same as the meet, I feel confident that I could have gotten that 760 and everything would have been to plan. But that's, why you have the meet, and you try it out and you assess your weaknesses and you move forward. Overall, I'm so incredibly thankful for having the opportunity to even do this. I was fortunate enough that the squat, the deadlift, and the total were state records, and Roger and Allie, the owners of the gym, were paying out cash, $100 for each state record up to two. So I walked out there with a couple hundred bucks to help pay for gas on the way home, and Gen X Labs also offered I believe it was a $500 prize package. It's not money, it's a pack of product from them, and that was for the Outstanding Lifter Award. And so I was again fortunate enough to earn a hard-fought battle. I was able to edge out some other really strong guys and get the Outstanding Lifter Award for the men's open raw division. So that was really awesome. Even though I didn't get the exact total I wanted, this is definitely the most successful meet I've ever had, in that I went 8 out of 9 attempts with one extra credit on my own. The best meets I've ever done have only ever been 7 out of 9, so that marks an improvement. I feel like I'm finally getting my groove. I feel like I'm finally figuring out some programming, and I had such a blast talking to people. I am so excited to get back to training. I have a few things. I learned a lot from this experience, and I am so excited to put all of that into practice. So thank you all for watching. Thank you all so much for the continued support. It means more to me than any of you will ever know. And if I had the chance to talk to you this weekend, thank you so much. Just thank from the bottom of my heart. This experience was amazing, and you guys made it that. So I will get back to training as soon as I can get some recovery in, and we'll see how things go from here. Thanks again. Talk to you soon. Bye.